When you are learning Revit, it's critical that you understand the difference between type properties and instance properties. An instance property will only update for the single element instance, whereas a type property will update for all element instances of that family type. So let's take a look at some examples. I'm going to zoom in and select a wall. And then you can see here in the properties palette that there are several parameters. Any parameter that appears here in the properties palette is an instance parameter. In other words, it's only going to affect the element that you have selected, or the elements that are selected. You can select multiple elements and modify the instance parameters for all of those instances at once. So let's start with just one here. So I have one wall selected. I'm going to change the top constraint to unconnected, and then I'm going to change the unconnected height to 20 feet. I can simply move the cursor out of the properties palette, and it will apply any parameter updates that I made. And you can also click apply here at the bottom. Just show that one more time. You can click apply, or you can simply move the cursor out of the properties palette and it will apply. Now you can see the wall height has updated for just the wall that I had selected. Now I'm going to select two walls. I'll press Control and select the other wall. And now I will make a similar change. Let's change it to 25 feet. So now I changed an instance parameter for two walls at the same time. And a way you can tell how many you have selected is by looking here in this drop-down, and it shows the category that you have selected along with the number of elements in that category that are selected. Now I can just quick kind of getting off track here, but if I select, use a window select to select multiple elements, and then expand the drop-down, you can see all the various categories that I have selected along with the number. So if I select walls, then you can see the instance parameters for the walls that I have selected. So now, in this case, you see top constraint and it says varies. So that means I have two elements selected that have varying top constraint parameters. So if you see varies, it means you have two or more elements selected with varying parameter values there. Okay, so an instance parameter will just update for that single element instance, or the multiple instances if you have multiple selected. Now, if you want to adjust a type property, you can select an element and then click Edit Type, and it will open the Type Properties dialog, which once again controls the type parameters for all instances of that type. So depending on the element that you're working with, these parameters will vary, obviously. In this case, let's do something simple like add a type mark. So I'll type A1, and then I'm going to click OK. Now, that doesn't adjust any geometry, but I can select another wall and click Edit Type. And when I scroll down, I can see the type mark is A1 because it is a wall of that same type. Now, if I select another wall and change the type, let's change it to an 8-inch masonry wall. And then let me open the type properties dialog. You can see that there's not a type mark because it's a different type. But I can add a type mark for this wall type, and then it will be available for all elements of that type. All right, let's take a look at a couple more examples here. Let's look at some structure elements. So I'm going to select a structural column, and then let's adjust the base offset to -5 feet. And you can see the bottom of this column extends down, whereas the other ones remain the same. If I select the column and click Edit Type, I can see all of the type properties, and anything adjusted here will affect all columns of this type. All right, another thing I want to point out here is I can select an element. So let's say sometimes as we're showing type properties and instance properties, there may be multiple instance properties that you want to update. And maybe you want to update all of the certain instance parameter for all elements of a specific type. And so if you want to do that, an easy way is to select one of the elements of the specific type you want to update, right-click, and then choose Select All Instances, and then you can select Visible in View or in Entire Project. So I'll select in Entire Project, and now you can see all of those columns update. And now I can adjust the base offset for all of them at once. So for example, I'll change it to -4 feet. And now they are all equal at -4 feet. Now, if you're dealing with loadable families, you can adjust some parameters. So as long as it's not a built-in, and not to get too deep into family creation topics here, but if it's a custom parameter that you created, you can adjust it from a type to an instance. But some of them, such as base offset and top offset that we're working with here, they can't be adjusted. But they need to be instance parameters because sometimes they need to vary from instance to instance. And so using the select all methods is an easy way to do that. All right, let's take a look at one more example here. I'll select an air terminal. And I'm going to adjust the elevation from level to 7 feet, which is an instance parameter. So you can see it moved down for just that instance. Then I'll click Edit Type. And I'm going to change the diffuser width to 4 feet. Just, I know that's not a logical value, but let's just do it. You can see the diffuser height updates as well. That's, if you see something like that, there's just a formula in the family that's at work. And then I'll click OK. And now you can see that both air terminals updated. Once again, I know that's not a 4-foot by 4-foot air terminal is not something you would use, but just to show, updating a type property updates all instances of that type, whereas updating an instance property only affects the single instance that was selected and updated.
Howdy! Thanks for watching. If you'd like more free content from Click to BIM, please like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel. We also have affordable subscription options at click2bim.com, where you can access all of our videos. We also have an amazing search feature that allows you to search through every single word in all of our videos to help you quickly find the answers to your questions.